So I'm going to demonstrate the materials, tools that I use when anchoring on a jet ski. I use a number 4 fluke anchor. I have a breakaway system set up, 3/16 stainless steel rope, gives clearance for the fluke to swing and strong enough to hold. 1/4 inch galvanized link chain, simple bowline knot. I tape this up to not get caught on rocks, the fray. I use this rope. This is a bowline mule tape. It's 3/4 inch. The tensile strength is 2,500 pounds. In this bag is 300 feet. I like using it because it's light. It dries fast. It's very strong. I'm gonna show you. This is what happens when it gets hooked on a rock. I had to re-splice it. I tie loops ahead of time. This one's at 25 feet. There's no markings for that. The next marking for the next loop is going to be at 50 feet, which I mark it in orange. Another 25 feet, another rock incident. 25 feet gives me 75. At 100 feet, it's yellow. One mark means 100 feet, two of them is 200 feet. Now, you notice how I laid it down on here? I do the same thing putting it back in. If you do it any other way, making loops, wrap it around your arm, you're gonna get knots. And it's gonna be quite a pain when you're working with your anchor. And the reason why I do these loops ahead of time is once your anchor is set, the last thing you want to be doing is holding your jet ski and holding the anchor while the jet ski is drifting away, trying to tie up a knot. So imagine you're doing a knot like this and all of a sudden it pulls, your fingers are in there, you can get caught up, it can pull you off the jet ski. With the pre-tied loops, you hook right up, right away. You save the time. I use this laundry bag so that when I'm done, I hang it up outside, fluff it up, dries really fast. This is a padded bag, Sam's Club. Use the to keep, I guess, frozen food, cold food. You notice inside how it's ripped, pretty beat up from the anchor. It's bounced around inside the jet ski. This anchor is about, this bag is about 2 seasons old. Probably next year I'm gonna get a new one. So this is my anchor bag. It's all set to go. The anchor line. This is what I use to tie to the front of the jet ski. Get some plastic hooks. 5200 sticks pretty well. All right, well, here's my line. And as you can see, it's tied to here. I replace this every season. You can see it's starting to wear down. I keep it past the hook so it's not caught inside, as it won't rub on it, weaken it. Simply put this on like a cleat on a boat dock. The compartment. They use this rubber lining. They use this in showers. This is the base's waterproofing in a shower base. This protects the inside of the jet ski, the anchor bouncing around and everything, as you saw in that bag. This bag is most of the time empty. You see the holes still from the anchor. So imagine without that padding, without that lining, what kind of damage it would do to the inside of the jet ski. I try to keep this thing full, minimize the bouncing around of everything. So I put that bag, which has nothing in there, another dry bag for some clothes. warmer jacket, rain gear, buoy, manual bilge, and then the jet ski bag on top of everything. So it's not tight, but it definitely cuts down on the bouncing around that goes on in this thing. Okay. One other piece I use for anchoring is this stainless steel 3/8 spring lock. And I'll show you how everything works together. So what I do is grab my spring link. Grab the line that's attached to the front of the ski. Secure it into a pre-tied loop. Flip it to the side. Now I'm ready for my anchor. Open up all the way just enough. You'll see how easy this comes out. All right, so now ready, I lower my anchor in. And I let line out. Now important thing about this bull line mule tape is that it sinks. You should let it out as it's pulling. Don't throw all your line out at once. That's why when I did that, what happens is it sinks, gets caught on a rock, and when you try to pull it back up, it actually starts ripping away at the line. This line is very strong, but it's not abrasive resistant. As soon as it gets onto some rocks or something sharp, it starts fraying, you see. So this one time happened to me, I had to redo that line and splice it. So again, this is 25 feet. I like to know how much line is out, so I know I'm setting the right amount of length so I can get good catch. It's usually 6 to 1, but I do more or less 3 to 1. Okay, so here's my 50 foot mark. Now I know I have 50 feet of line out. Once my anchor's set and I know I have a good hold, I then take this, that's tied to the front of the ski, link it up, and then I let it out. Still keep letting it go out, and I'll show you. What it looks like. There it is. So what I like to do is, this is the retrieval line so I can pull it back to the jet ski and unhook everything. I like to keep this tight, not tighter than the anchor line obviously, but just enough so it stays close to it, not away, so when you're fishing you're not having to worry about your anchor line and this line getting your hooks into it. So once I've established I have enough slack out there, I simply take this, put it through my cleat, so I can reach down for it later on and retrieve it. Throw this back in there. And I'm done. Now the retrieval. Again, retrieving it. Don't do loops, don't do hand over fist. Just simply take the line and lay it in the bag. Now I can do this without using the jet ski power if the current's not Looks like I got hooked. This doesn't happen when I'm out there because I don't have a trailer with me. So I normally, as I was saying, retrieve this not using jet ski power. Too many moving parts to have it on accidentally hitting the throttle. This one, you see how the bag sits up here. If the current's not too strong, I'm able to pull the anchor line in and the jet ski. This took this off the wrong line. I'm gonna take it off the anchor line. I take the line that goes to the ski, secure it there. So as I retrieve, like I said, at this point, you're pulling now the jet ski in towards the anchor. If you're not fighting the current, the wind, it's possible. If you are, and you have to kick this on, I steer the handlebars with my body, and I just keep it in gear, and I take some of the tension off, some of the weight. Jet ski helps me pull it towards the anchor. Set it up on here. Zip her up. I like to keep the anchor on top of, or this on top of the anchor, because the anchor jumping around might cause this to punch through, have the hooks come through. And it's important to be able to tie this up inside, because if you leave it out, the movement of the jet ski in the water, it will pull this line out of the compartment. I'm looking for a better way to secure this in here. I haven't figured anything else out yet, but so you imagine a water down there coming across, it'll pull that line right out and it'll be the outside of your jet ski. Take the D-ring, throw it back in the compartment. That's basically it. 4 or 5 seasons of this. It's been flawless.